Welcome to it, people. Time for another edition of the rounds. Welcome to it. We're going to pour a pint of knowledge here for you today. And kind of a high-intensity day, so we're going to do big things. We bring you the freshest and tastiest in all the brews here on the rounds. My name, of course, is Glenn. Welcome to it. We're swinging out to Chico, California, or Asheville, North Carolina. Maybe both. Take your pick. We're going to hit up the guys at Sierra Nevada, who have been doing it since 1980. Today's deal, if you guys get a good scope at that there. The Hoptimum. Now, over the course of, I think last year was really the first time I'd heard about the Hoptimum. I didn't get a chance to try it. I was very, very excited about the idea. The reason for this is Sierra Nevada does a fantastic job of being every bit the hophead that I am. They are one of the larger craft breweries in America. And what I love about it is they tend to be hop-focused kind of year-round, really. They have the Southern Hemisphere release, which is a wet hop, fresh ale, or a fresh hopped ale. Then they also have the Northern Hemisphere, which comes out during the harvesting of the Northern Hemisphere's hops. They have their estate grown and Hoptimum. So, nice effervescence. Really nice effervescence. Gorgeous color to it. The head seems to be a bit thick, but I'm betting that'll break down a bit. Hoptimum is 10.4% alcohol by volume, 100 IBUs. And they're touting big things on the research information, because they say they use Simcoe and Secret hops, and then Simcoe and Secret hops, and then it's torpedoed with Citra and Chinook. So kind of a big deal in the hops area, because they have these Secret hops, new exclusive varietals. Should be good things. Now, for the malt bill, if I remember right, there's at least five or six malts in here. But they still didn't go too dark on it. Still got a good bit of that orange hue to it. Honestly, you know, if you didn't show somebody the bottle, you may even be able to fool them into thinking that was the pale ale. I think the pale ale is slightly more red. But in terms of color, that's pretty light for this behemoth beer that we're talking about in theory. This 100 IBU, 10.4% alcohol by volume. You know, five different hops. So keep that in mind. Really nice effervescence. I definitely get the Simcoe. And there's more lurking in the wings. Not super stinky. Not an absolutely huge bouquet. Ooh, I just got, like, tropical fruit, like dragon fruit or something. I got, what the frick is the name of it? It's kind of a purplish on the outside, and then it's kind of green with white in the middle. Not a kiwi. It might be a passion fruit. Yeah. Yeah, that's totally, like, passion fruity. That's really interesting. Good color. The head is sticking around pretty well, actually. It is definitely a well-strategized hop assault. But I am getting a lot of fruity esters out of them. I know for a fact part of that must lie in the malt bill. The other part of that, however, could be these new varietals of hops. But that is a funky deal. And instantly just became, like, right up there with my favorite hop behemoths, like Maharaja and Leviathan. And, I mean, there's a lot of them out there now. I mean, a lot more than there used to be, but there are some that fall within a given alcohol content and a given IBU range that I think are just done so phenomenally. The alcohol does present a little hot. And some respects, this almost does drink like a barley wine. Some of these big boys, Maharaja, Optimum, a few of them, actually, they are, you know, Imperial IPAs. They drink a lot more like barley wines. To most people, they're just going to be too intense to really enjoy. I love them. I definitely love them. Now, I like these better than I like barley wines. The hop flavor here is just amazing. Okay, so 4-pack will run you $10.99. Run you $11 in my neck of the woods. And I gotta recommend them. I think Sierra Nevada has been doing great things and is on the verge of some really huge stuff. If you didn't know, they've just signed for an expansion. They are going to officially be a bi-coastal brewery, which I think is a really cool idea. So they'll maintain their headquarters in Chico and pimp the East Coast via Asheville, or as a lot of people know, Beer Town, USA. Congratulations to you, Sierra Nevada. Thank you. Thank you so much for being a hop head and inspiring guys like me. Get out there, drink American, drink independent, people, drink to your health, most importantly. We'll see you next time on the rounds. Thanks for swinging by.